So back in 2015, ECMAScript 6 introduced so much different things. And some of the things I'm going to be talking about in this video is the things that they enhanced to the object literal syntax. So things like shorthand properties and computed property names. So if I explain shorthand property really quick, so let's say we have two variables declared and then we create an object. I can just simply put user ID in here, and because user ID has already been declared and set, the shorthand property of ES6 automatically pulls in that value of it because it's already been declared. And then similarly, instead of having to write out function, log details, and then creating my function or log details equals function, it understands that when you have a parameter right here, you're trying to create a function. So you don't have to write all those words out anymore. So shorthand properties. And if I press run, it operated as normal, even without the additional assignment and without the actual saying of the word function in there. So it's very straightforward. But yeah, it's the little things, right? And computed property names is exactly that. So you can see in this object that I've created, that the property name itself is being set via an expression. So I'm adding the word is to this variable that I've brought in called that is set to status. And then down here, I'm looking specifically in this object for is status. But you can see here there's no is status property that's set directly. It's all via a computed property name. So if I press run, still found it as true because that property name is there via script. Cool. I say cool a lot, don't I? Ugh.